yourself you're gonna have a great day. Manifesting is so important. I like am a strong believer in manifesting and putting out positivity, and you'll get positivity in return. So also, when things go wrong, instead of getting upset about it or wondering why is this happening to me, I've been not getting upset about it and just saying this was meant to be like this. Things will get better and things have been looking up. I was super down and out like a couple weeks ago and I'm a new person, I feel like. So I don't know why I just wanted to go on that tangent. I feel like somebody out there watching right now is going through it mentally. I know this whole year, I think everybody has just gone through it mentally and everyone's just so tired of this year. You guys should be proud of me because I haven't put my Christmas tree up yet, and this time last year, I think she was already up, but I have been listening to Christmas music, and only because I work at Ulta, so the retail stores, I haven't honestly been into another store that plays music in a while, but I don't know if they have started playing Christmas music or not, but Ulta does. You know, I just realized, like, my work day, I feel like, goes by so much faster because there's music constantly playing. Now, I couldn't imagine working at a place that doesn't have music. Like, if I were to go work at Target, which I used to, or, like, Walmart or Kroger or somewhere, they don't play music. It's just weird to think about when I'm so used to hearing music all day at work. Anyone else who works in retail and has music playing feel that same way? I don't know. Okay. I am all over the place tonight, you guys. So I'm sorry that I'm just being super random, but that is the beauty of a whispered ramble. It's just to ramble on about random things. So, okay, let's bust into these questions. Someone asked, what star sign are you? I am a Gemini. I'm a Gemini through and through. I literally, all of the characteristics of a Gemini is me, for sure. Someone asked, what are your favorite drinks, alcohol? Ooh, this is good. Okay, so I don't know why this is my go-to drink. It has been for the longest time. It's a Bud Light. I think they're disgusting, but it's always just the go-to for me. I don't know why. I don't personally really like liquor. Like, I hate shots. I think they're disgusting, but I do them anyway because, you know, it's a shot. But ordering an actual drink that has liquor in it just is not appealing. I got a vodka Red Bull the other day. I'm just not a fan. I don't really like liquor that much. So Bud Light, I started drinking Natty Lights as my first ever beer when I was like 12. And then I upgraded, if you will, to Bud Light. I just am not really a fan of the taste of alcohol in general. So I think I stick to kind of the lighter beers. I can't do anything hoppy. I can't do any IPAs. Dark beer, no ma'am. Count me out. I don't really like going to breweries for that reason. Every time I go to a brewery, I always ask them what beer tastes the most like a Bud Light. blanking. This Is Us. Oh my gosh, if you guys want to cry every 10 minutes, watch This Is Us. I still have yet to get through it all. I started it during quarantine. And then, I don't know. I haven't gotten back into it. Okay, let's see. Someone asked, how has work been with COVID and everything? Girl, it's been a hot mess, let me tell ya. So, we've been back since, like, mid-May. And we started off doing curbside only. And then we went back to opening. And we could only have 40 people in our store. Masks were not required at the time. But now that they're mandatory, I've gotten in literal arguments with customers over not wearing a mask. Like, I'm like, just wear the freaking mask. You're gonna be in it for 10 minutes. I have to be in here for 8.5 hours wearing this thing. You're gonna be okay. And people just make it seem like they go into other stores that don't require it. I know a lot of gas stations, I never see people wearing them in gas stations, but as far as like Kroger and Target and Ulta, they require you to have it. They have people at the front door making sure you're wearing one. So where are you going that you don't need a mask? I don't know. I just think it's ridiculous that people want to fight it. Apparently, this right now going on is the most cases we've had since it even started, like before the shutdown. So this is really when we should have been shutting down. I think they just got freaked out in the beginning because they didn't know what this disease was and whatnot, but it's getting worse. Also, I feel like there's some controversy going on with my video, like, destroying the products at work. I saw a lot of, like, comments and a lot of people kind of, like, defending me. I wouldn't say it's defending, but I guess a lot of people just saying, like, it's my job. So basically, I have to destroy products. So if someone returns a product, especially now more than ever, even if they say they didn't use it, it's just, if the seal is still on it, then we know it was never even opened. But if the seal was opened, even if they said they didn't try it or anything, you still don't know. You know, they could have opened it. Stuff could have gotten in it. I don't know. It's just, why would you not? I know the whole protocol is crazy. I know there are people out there who we could donate it to. But at the same time, if we don't feel comfortable reselling it, then why would we give it to somebody else and risk them getting infected? You know, I don't know. That was just kind of my mentality. I think it's crazy that we have to do it. It hurts my soul. I have had to damage a product that was worth over $100. And it was just like barely touched. I don't know. Sorry, that just like made me think about it. But it's definitely different. You know, we have no testers. We can't help people color match. We can just like put it up to their face. And people are returning stuff all the time. You can't smell fragrances. And it's just, oh, it's awful. It's really sad. So yeah. What's up? Okay, he said, have you been able to tell your boyfriend about your channel? I know you resented it before. By the way, miss you, bud. I miss you so much. Okay, so I think previously in a video I talked about, I don't know if I called him my boyfriend or if I just talked about a guy that I was talking to, but we're in a very messy, maybe it's not messy. It's complicated, a complicated situation. One of the most complicated situations I've ever been a part of, but we agreed we're not boyfriend and girlfriend. We've been talking for like 3.5 months. We basically are without the label, you know. It's confusing, but I'm happy, you know. I was the one who kind of agreed to that we're not going to be official for at least another month or two. But anyway, I did tell him. He is the first guy that I've been able to tell about my channel, and he is like all for it. And it's like so nice to openly be like, oh, I have to film some videos today, or sorry, I won't be able myself doing something with the addiction field. I did work at a rehab, if you guys are familiar with me and, you know, my life last year, and I really found a passion for it, and I'm currently taking classes. I've been taking classes for the last year and a half, but it's not like a set time. It's just ones like these classes that I bought, and then you just kind of do it at your own time. But definitely doing something to get my CDCA to be able to help people with addiction. That's my main goal in life, my main career choice. And then any advice for people who are lost in life? Girl, I've been lost. I still kind of feel lost in life, but I feel like sometimes you just gotta lose yourself. You gotta lose everything. Hit that rock bottom. To really just see your potential and see what you want to do with your life. It took me 24 years to figure out what I wanted to do with my life. Finding that career choice, I didn't really think too much about that growing up. You know, there was addiction in my family, alcoholism and drug addicts and whatnot, and I didn't really think about doing a career with it until I actually tried it. And if you're lost in life, I guess kind of just going out of your comfort zone, trying new things, and really just finding what you like, and finding something you're passionate about is the most important thing, and it'll come to you, you know, in time. Definitely trying not to rush the process, is the best thing I can think of. So I still have a long ways to go before I can get into that field with my classes and everything. So I know what I want to do, and now I just have to work on it and, you know, just at my own time. So just try and get out there, find things you love to do, and, you know, maybe try it as a hobby if possible, or if it's, you know, leaving the job you're at now and just trying something completely new. Just taking chances is really what's going to help you figure it out. So I hope that helped you. But anyway, if you're going through a hard time, feel free to reach out to me. I would love to talk to you guys. I hope everyone is doing well and staying safe.